pop the tire.
That's our luggage on the runway right now.
That was short.
Fucking slept through the
whole thing.
You're lucky.
Look at the assistant.
Ed Edge.
Wait, it's from Ed Edge.
Wait.
Everybody.
Dave told me to text you when I got here. Hope to see you soon. Everyone talks funny here. Oh, how weird for you, Ed. It's so strange. So strange.
Oh, yeah, he probably told the promoter he's the triangle player, not the tour manager.
I'm gonna steal his triangle from him.
You know he brought it.
Of course he did.
Oh, yeah, he did.
You want me to get rid of it? I will. I want it gone.
Yeah.
All right. Awesome.
It's funny.
He's gonna cry, you guys.
You guys.
I'll give it back
like
to
a
him.
Little animal.
I'll give it back to him later. When he's dead.
Don't you guys realize that the triangle is more famous than anything else?
Can you even hear the triangle when you guys play?
Actually, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, it's really loud.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
I can't wait to hear it.
Dude.
Film right now. And how are those vegetables?
Vegetables?
Isn't it cool that we made sure there was vegan food for you everywhere?
Not vegan anymore.
What?
I'm
scared
of the dog.
You're not vegan anymore?
No, man.
It's because of that bitch girlfriend who turned you into
dude,
a...
Dude, it has nothing to do with her.
Giant thank you to the random drunk guy with the toilet plunger. You are the fury. You are tomorrow. Keep hope alive. Obey the triangle.
Great. This is the best sound so far.
I've been having aggression problems on this tour, and I've been taking it out on people who are having too much fun. There's some dude with a plunger out here somewhere, but I don't know where he went.
It's fun.
Hello, hello.
You had so much fun tonight.
Dude's fucking funny! Woo!
Dude, you had a fucking great time, and because of you,
I was pumped.
Yeah, okay. Hello. Turn back. Be quiet, please. People are sleeping.
Okay.
Old band. Old band left your band. Stupid.
Awesome.
He's
great.
He's the boss. He's the fucking...
In no time. That was so good, man. You don't even know. I was watching you, and you were fucking rocking. And it was so good.
All right, fucking like you. would you like my shit pump?
Is this for me?
I knight you, Sir Toilet a lot. Please keep the strength and the virtue and the valor of the people of the world. You have been christened thus.
Please remember me.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Can we trust this guy?
Not most definitely.
No, I hate this guy.
I'm sorry, that's all.
You didn't see it.
Bye, bye. I just farted on him.
Okay.
Peter.
Hi.
Here.
Thank you.
An inspiration to us all.
Ed, tell us a story.
Okay, so the reason why I'm now sleeping on beds and I'm not vegan anymore and I'm happy and healthy and taking medicine and all that stuff is that I got saved.
What?
By yeah. Jesus?
You're yeah. Christian?
Yeah, man.
What?
Oh!
Wait, what?
What? What?
What's wrong
what
with that?
What happened to
man?
Buddha?
Well, Buddha was good for like 11 years of being unhealthy and vegan and not taking medicine with heart disease and having the weight of the world on your shoulders.
Why do you need a religion to make those kinds of decisions?
I don't know. It's I'm happier now. I'm in a better place.
But Jesus doesn't even like dark-skinned people.
Yeah. Did you know that?
What was he, a self-loather?
A self-loather.
She just was a self-loather, new black metal band.
Wow. That's really the reason?
Yeah, man.
You've abandoned your Buddhist faith for Christian faith?
This is so awesome, dude.
That's very Virginia.
I don't think that.
Oh, fuck. How could you become any more of an enigma?
My little sister, the first thing she says, like, wow, you can sleep on the bed now? Awesome. No, my parents are just happy I'm taking medicine, so that's good.
Ray wants to know when you're going to break edge.
That's never gonna happen, though.
Yeah, I mean, at some point, sacrament will have to be ingested.
You buy like a temple.
You have to drink the blood of Christ and accept the Eucharist.
Yeah, it's well, it's just grape juice.
Yeah, I guess.
You don't want the real deal?
Jesus was into wine, dude. He turned the water into wine.
So unspoiled.
Yeah, obviously, like wine.
All my Christian friends drink. They had a Super Bowl party and they had Heineken there.
Heineken?
Yes.
What?
What?
Let's get it.
Alright. The sound guy admittedly
nothing about sound. He just knows how to adjust the knobs. He doesn't know how the sound system works. Doesn't even know how to turn the lights on. They're staring at the same group of wires, going...
I wake up like 15 times because my ribs hurt. It's so pussy. Like, back in the day, I didn't give a fuck. I could sleep on the floor. No problems. Now it's like, I need like 4 air mattresses like stacked up.
How many do you have?
None.
Dave, I'll see you in... Where are we going?
Latvia.
How long is it gonna take?
But it's going to be like 16 hours at least because of the quality of road.
Like emo.
So I've heard.
Side profile, no hand. Nice.
Majestic.
Can you see if the buildings behind that huge nose of mine?
Some of them.
So maybe I'll be able to fit in some tighter jeans from now on. Maybe it'll shrink up on me.
I'm so happy right now.
Why?
Because we're in Finland.
Helsinki.
Happy to be home.
Welcome to Helsinki.
I got the end of all things all queued up.
Nice. That's a different...
Oh,
that's,
shit. That's... I got Moon Sorrow all queued
up. Yeah, there you go.
Hi, my name is Nathan. We are in Finland. This may be the worst show ever.
And every night of your life, you do the same thing, and you're nothing more than a fucking clown.
No, I'm not a clown.
I feel that way sometimes.
Aww.
Oh, good call! Dude, you caught us off guard with that one.
You guys have all been really entertaining tonight, too. Especially you, dude.
got all these ailments all the time. What happens next?
We're going to the ferry.
Ferry has three things: restaurant, dance club, hookers.
Casino.
Oh, and casino, four things. It's gonna be awesome.
On this boat, you relax for 12 hours as you are magically whisked away to Stockholm.
Ahoy.
Ahoy. Baltic Sea, for you and me. Got waves. Tonight there's gonna be raves. Sunlight, feel all right. Everything's fucking out of sight.
Oh.
So what?
How's the trip been these last couple of weeks?
I'm getting bored. You know?
Me too.
After a while, just people saying shit you don't understand and food you don't know what it is. It's the same thing after 2 months. You know, a question mark is always a question mark. You know, like, you can only handle so much confusion before you're just fucking confused. I mean, definitely the girls in the East Europe look better, but fucking in love, so it doesn't matter. By the way, it's my girlfriend's fucking birthday today. Woo, baby, I love you. I'm on the ocean.
Okay.
You guys are all filing through cash.
Sarah, guess what I'm filming?
My crotch.
Crotchety crotch.
Hey! Don't.
That was said without much conviction, Sarah.
I need to eat, damn it.
Pizza's out of 10.
What time is it? Tell me.
9:40.
Oh, 20 minutes.
You just want your cut.
What are you doing? All this mixing shit.
What are you doing?
Just
I bet it all on black.
My tongue
okay,
hurts.
I just drink it and I get looks. I mix it and I get guff.
What's a guff?
Guff.
You, just now.
That was guff. Just drink it.
Dude.
I'll just drink it.
We could totally grift it.
Sarah, get up. We're going to the club, girl. Come on. Some dude out there asking about you all night. Side note, in Hungarian, Sara means someone else's shit.
Buying drinks for minors.
Buying drinks for minors on a boat. My coolest friend is also my biggest loser of a friend.
No, he's not. He's having the most fun.
I know, dude. Look at him, dude. Everybody knows how awesome this is.
I love this song!
Where are the chicks at, fags? They're 11. Look at Dave's mad style. Check out these moves. Yeah. Oh. Oh, look at that style. Okay, there's a girl right next to him. Who's she dancing with? Another girl. Who's Dave dancing with? I don't know. Who's Gary dancing with? I don't know. What the fuck is Eric doing? Founders of Horse the Band. Ha 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 ha!
15-year-olds.
Ed's victory. Ed!
Where are my friends? I want to go.
Come on, let's dance.
More time. I have to go.
Oh. Wait, I gotta get this on film. Say hello.
Hello.
What's your name? And where are you from?
Estonia.
Why are you here? Why are you here?
Because we have a class trip.
E-E-Instrom, where are you at? E-E-Instrom, where are you at? E-E-Instrom. Ed, we got you, dude. Christ is not watching you right now. Oh, God, Gary. What you did. Those two bitches just made out for their entertainment, but I missed it by like 4 seconds. Fuck. Do it again! Be famous! Good deal. Fair enough. You fucking hookers. I hope you get pregnant.
At one point, I just watched you cut in and like bump that old chick out of the way. I just start grinding up on Gary, and you literally just like push her out of the way. Look at her.
I'm fucking dancing with my man.
We arrive.
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 Ed. We had a good night, Ed.
Yes.
Eric.
Yes.
You know it.
Nathan. Dash? Dave? Sarah, what happened?
Sarah, someone's shit.
Someone's shit.
It's terrible.
Was it plop? Was it a plop bar?
Plop?
Eric.
I was looking everywhere for it, and it was under my
desk. Where's my chocolate? I
couldn't find it because in my butt.
Where's my chocolate?
Has anyone seen my chocolate?
Yaki,
you're a fucking loser.
Could you say, welcome to Sweden?
You know so much money.
And look at the camera.
First band from Los Angeles, and I'm glad you've had us here.
That is long. We got 1/1000th of your entire population to come to our first show. That's fucking amazing.
Percentages.
What are you most impressed with?
Most impressed? Most impressed. You know what, dude? I have to say, fucking Sarah.
our photographer. She has like no money, constantly getting made fun of, but she's always in such a good mood.
That's pretty good.
Isn't that the fucking, the weirdest thing? She always wakes up and like just starts laughing. I don't know how she does it.
Yeah, I don't know any other girl that could handle it.
Dude, it fucking keeps me going, man. I need it. Or else, I don't know what I would do out here. I really miss my girlfriend. I'm gonna see her in London. And then she's gonna ride with us for like a week. And then I'll be really happy. I mean, I feel so fortunate that I am dating the most beautiful girl in the entire world, you know? Like, how the fuck did I swing that one? I don't remember the statue.
No, this is the wrong way.
I've been with her for 5 years.
Yeah?
Five. That's the longest I've been with anybody. Since we were teenagers. Man, she's hot. I'm gonna get married if I had any money. Which I don't. If I had a credit card, I'd just put it on the credit card.
Yeah.
The horse the band way. Nathan's a great guy. He just gets out of control sometimes and really blows me out. But I love him to death, so I don't stay pissed off for too long. I actually had a talk with him about it though, and he said that I was the same way. And which is totally not true. Because I'm never vocal about my fucking issues. I just don't talk to anybody for a week. Dude, we're totally lost. Fucking Gary.
Honest.
Dude, in Transylvania, it was like the worst show for me for some reason. And then during Face of Bear, I look at you, and you had your face mask, your fucking monopod. Your leg. You just made me smile, and it put me in such a good mood. I love you, man. The meaning of life. I know this one. The meaning of life, my friend, is love. True love. Like, I love my girlfriend. She loves me, and that's why I wake up every morning. But not only that, fucking love from your family. My mom and my dad love me, I know that. It's a reason to wake up every morning. You know, love from your friends. Loving and being loved is what it means to live. I'm totally serious. I truly believe this. Do you agree? Because serious? Without that, what's the point?
Nintendo Core.
Oh yeah, well there's always Nintendo Core. And without Nintendo Core, fuck. What would we do? You know, and there's music and stuff. The music's awesome. And it's a reason to live too. But I'd sacrifice music for love any day. I think. Well, I have love for music. I love music.
You're conflicted now.
I know. Fuck. Well, that's loving something though. So it's in the same category. Just loving stuff. Just having love in your heart. You know, everybody in this band always says nothing matters. And it's just dumb.
You said it.
I know. I just say it because it's like the thing you say when you're in this band. I think I'm ready for bed.
It's a really good band.
What?
That you're a part of.
Horace the Band. It's weird. It's a weird band to be in. I'll tell you that. Fuck.
Hi. This is Norway. We're here in Oslo. Ed Edge is a guest host today. Alright, so my experience with Norway is this so far. Everyone is hotter and taller than me, and my self-esteem is in the pooper. So I want to go back to Detroit where I feel good about myself.
So you're admitting that I'm hotter and taller than you?
Yes, if we did a poll right now. How are you?
Hi. I got these Christian Dior sunglasses today. And also, this girl over my right shoulder deserves a zoom in the all black sitting on the bricks.
His right shoulder's over there, by the way. Gary.
Can you be getting her right now, dude?
I found another.
We're Horace the Band from, I don't even fucking remember anymore. It's been like 67 days since we were home. We've been in like 27 countries. I've gotten like 30 new fucking penile infections. In 17 days, I'm gonna blow my brains all over the fucking Statue of Liberty. Tonight's show is brought to you by the word no. And the disease cancer.
Cancer.
I want to thank the band before us for the efficient removal of their equipment. Thank you. That was great.
I didn't see any. So, you guys drawn any pictures of Muhammad recently?
Yeah, every day.
Go. Fuck the Euro.
You have to take a shower.
So I'm fucking dirty.
Shower in the venue.
And here, where all the people have been chain smoking and fucking jerking off and breaking glass.
Way to go, homo. I think that was a drive-by. I don't know.
Was it really?
I don't know.
Sure it wasn't just a drunk fucking machismo moment?
I don't know.
Look at me, I'm fucking pissed.
We're in a bad neighborhood, I know that.
The hood of fucking Denmark. They have a whole vein of gangster rap coming here going, Riggen Dorgen Sogren, Tonin Chikolka, Abona Gakaka, and Otonin Yapa, and your mama's in the asshole and the puppet chupon, and your sister go, brrrr, what's in my baby bun? I'm gonna go. I got a bum bum bum, I got a gun. Thank you.
What could we do to spice our lives up?
Costumes.
Costumes?
Costumes would work.
I'm wide open. I think we need to get in some trouble.
Yeah, so, totally.
We need to get Nathan to drink a whole bottle one of these days.
Should we start drinking more?
Old style.
Maybe?
Like, not a lot, not like Nathan Party more, but like, just more.
I'm just too tired to.
I know, dude.
Like, I'll just fall asleep.
We gotta figure out a way to just wake ourselves up.
We just need to sleep one day.
For once.
Yeah, I mean, there's that. It's all
whatever.
Circumstance. Like,
I know, if it's a great crowd, it's just a great night. Everything's great.
It's just, the last week has sucked.
Good.
Plain and simple. Shitty shows.
This has been like the,
you've been driving the best move 7 hours a day and playing to shitty, small audiences.
Why horse the band?
Yes, good question. It was funny. My friend told me, he's like, I was like, all right. I sat down with my friends all the time. I was like, all right, what's hot? What are you listening to now? I need new clients. At the tender age.
That's the tender age.
I need like, some new clientele.
I need some new clients. And they said, all right, I got these two new CDs from Second Story Window.
Nice.
And Horse the Band. Called Derek from the Second Story Window, and I emailed Eric from Horse the Band. I got both of them, and I listened to From Second Story Window, and look at like their drawing potential. I was like, hey, dude, this is stupid. And it turns out it was the better choice. What are they doing nowadays? Nothing?
Nothing.
Okay, yeah. So good. I made the right decision.
Yeah, absolutely.
What's happening today here?
There's all these zombies. They're cool. What is one?
What you're experiencing is a special breed of human being that can only be found in this form of atmosphere. This here is a side dweller, also known as the human trash can. Over here, you can witness a breed known as the thinker.
He's thinking about something so hard.
15 minutes ago, he found his girlfriend fucking some guy in the bathroom.
Transcendentalism.
Yeah. Transnisteriism.
This is the sound guy in waiting?
Yes. Actually, he's probably already a professional.
So are you enjoying yourselves?
Look at these guys. They're just cheersing up there.
Watch they break it and they can't get down, dude. That'd be so funny.
I wish he just fucking, if they just gunned it and it tipped back, that'd be the best.
Wait, are these just random drunk dudes?
Yeah.
Let's have a dance party.
No, Gary.
White Cliffs of Dover here.
Where?
Behind me. Eli, our old drummer, said these weren't that cool. But he was a retard. Look at them. How could that not be cool to you? Ah.
Any parting words?
Can't miss you.
What? Any more?
We're going on another ferry?
I'm gonna miss you.
Another ferry.
That's amazing. We're dropping it
off. Oh, Sarah, keep up.
Sorry, guys. I've been not listening to music and just like not listening to anyone. Yeah. I said, what, are we getting on another ferry?
Wow. Wow.
That's what I said.
It's sketch. Like, wow.
Hi, Ed. Craig getting familiar.
Oh, fuck!
Holy crap.
Did I burn you?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, no.
You just took away from our goodbye.
Yeah.
Selfish.
Yeah, Dave, how dare you get burned on Sarah's careless cigarette maintenance.
Careless, I was talking Ed. Right.
I hope you don't get too bored at the airport.
Yeah.
This How long do you have to wait?
These next 21 hours at this airport are going to be the funnest 21
Excuse
hours of my
me?
Life.
21 hours?
Oh, yeah, sleeping bag.
Sometimes in life, you get happy, I don't know.
The show's over. How do you guys feel?
Trim this fucking piece of shit or just let it grow?
That's what the old U-turn said. Now look what happened to him.
The old U-turn.
Don't fucking compare me to that.
Put a little out, slip a little in.
Where'd you get that anyway?
Mubarak!
We bought this from the bar.
Inconceivable!
With money from Egypt.
No, the band bought that.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
What happened to Egypt, bitch?
Well, I mean, I'm paying it back. But as of right now.
Wait. This was supposed to be paying us back for what you've already...
What the fuck are you guys talking about?
You paid us back with a bottle of
Egypt. Okay, wait. Really quick, Sarah, look at everybody.
What was just said, dinks?
You paid us back with a bottle that you drank yourself.
Wait,
by using our money to buy it.
Guys!
She looks like a unicorn, right?
No.
You fucking dicks. What kind of a fucking setup is this?
Dude, better than most that we get here.
This is what life
welcome
used to
be.
Welcome
to luxury.
Like. Yeah, used to is the key word.
Do it yourself.
Traditional British accommodations. Third night in a row. 9 people to 1 bed.
I am 31.
You like this in here?
I feel pretty good.
We're hungry. We're loaded.
Wait, I'm urinating.
You're loaded.
I'm urinating as we speak.
Don't. Dave.
I'm right below you.
This song is one of the most important things that has happened in the 21st century so far.
Here we go. When you discover that a natural death sounds exactly the same as their last two records, it's a bit of a letdown. It's manic attention deficit stuff with the quintet seemingly bouncing off the studio walls, but while the riffs will grab you by the neck and drag you around with them, you just want to tell them to sit down and stop being quite so daft.
Your Nintendo Core gag barely endures.
Yeah, I don't think they...
Who's this?
Who?
Rob Dealey.
Misunderstood. I'll probably die before people completely understand me.
All the good artists do.
Do you think the cause is this grave? Mr. William Wallace?
Yes. But nobody knows what my cause is yet. I haven't explained it.
Jump on that.
That was a good time.
I read a manuscript to be found.
Fuck.
Oh shit. Now that they sound all musical and, like, you know, deliberate in their songwriting, this is crap.
Faggots.
Gary, we can't have this kind of hate, or else we're gonna have to go through all the footage before we send it to the TV show.
It's already too late. There's hate everywhere, and expletives, and racism.
I know. That's
homophobia.
We need to get the racism out.
It won't be hard. It's only 150 hours of footage.
John, I'm getting up in your nuts. Go for it.
Tim Smith. FYI, Roadrunner Oz is feeling your music, FYI. We'll be right back.
sound exactly like all the songs on our last two albums. If I were to rate this song on a scale of 5 Ks, I would give it 3.
Goodbye, Horse, the band. It's been really good.
Gary, I'm gonna cry.
Why, Eric?
Because I don't get to see Eva every day anymore.
It's a scrum.
The pussy size.
It feels so good.
Oh yeah.
It feels so great.
Oh no, should do. You've got a good band.
You got a good camera.
It's not that good.
No,
it's bright.
It is. Jared, who?
I don't know.
Next round.
Okay, my homophobia way outweighs my love of animals. Which would you rather?
Ask Dave, he's got the logic.
Have to watch a compilation montage of you masturbating on hidden camera while holding your parent's hand with them? Or...
That always comes up eventually.
Get one of your fingers chopped off.
Oh my god,
dude. A compilation of how long?
I don't know.
Well, like which episodes this
is. A montage usually lasts about
just like the gnarliest ones
the
of your life.
Of
you just felt like so dirty and horrible about yourself.
Like the ones where you ejaculated onto your own shit in a public bathroom.
For this next song, I'd like to thank the entire music industry for growing giant fucking labias over the past 20 years to the point that every fucking rock band is a vegan, straight-edge, sensitive little girl, and that every band with any balls on earth has slowly died off and committed suicide because they understand that their future is in Walmart.
Guys, this language barrier between us is killing me. There's so much I'd like to say to you, but you don't understand any of it. Guys, was the all-time low show this good? I doubt it. We're way bigger than them in the US, and also way bigger here. I'm supposed to meet a girl tomorrow in Paris who ditched me in Austria.
Oh.
And all of my clothes are dirty and they smell bad.
You're doing laundry!
But I'm doing my laundry. So I think tomorrow is going to be a success. Because she's paying for the train ticket to Paris.
A number 12 fan just hugged me while I was pissing in the bathroom. And it was really awesome. Because, you know.
We told you your fans aren't facts. I mean homosexuals. I didn't mean that in any negative connotation whatsoever. I used to live with a gay guy. I totally don't care.
I know a gay guy.
I also know a gay guy. One of my friends is black.
What's your choice?
Have you guys ever heard of a game called Would You Rather?
Would you rather eat a turd coming out of somebody's body or bite the crowning head of a baby coming out of a woman? What would you rather do?
All right, here's one. Would you rather have a compilation highlight video of all of your worst masturbation moments of your life made and have to watch it with your parents while holding their hands?
Or
live in Wales?
What's the name of your band?
So hey, what's, I mean, come on, yeah, what's going on? You did fuck up.
Another overnight drive dash.
I know, I'm stoked.
Amped?
Yeah. So this is why I do this, really. Just the promises of overnight drives is enough for me.
Never done a tour with this many in my career.
Did you just tape your fart?
It's been a lot.
Yes.
Gross. Did you eat an egg salad sandwich?
I had several.
Ew!
You guys have a slumber party going up there, eh?
Here we go.
With a loft hydra.
Slumber hell.
Maybe heading down to the floor again.
Again. Back to my true home.
Colonize it.
Dude, Nathan just spice clouded up here and it's fucking sick!
There is one of
Snaggy.
Well, this is different than the other one.
What a fucking nightmare. What's going on here?
We are moving or changing vans for the, what is this, the fourth time?
Fifth time.
There's about a 4-hour block of time between when we need to leave our old van and pick up our new van. And all of our stuff
again,
is limbo.
All of our shit on the street for everyone to look at, including that.
Sarah. How are you feeling?
Tired. Homesick. Bored.
Gay Perry.
Wee wee. It's not as gay. It's crazy. As they make it out to be. Although, maybe it is gay. In the negative sense. Although I didn't really see any of it. Didn't even see the Eiffel Tower.
3 weeks to go, Sarah.
20 days, Gary.
The final countdown.
I haven't said anything funny in over a year. Now I just make self-satisfactory comments that give me later moments for masturbation. Shut up. I'd like to thank everybody who has never seen us before and must be horribly suicidal at this point.
This song is called Murder.
The best part about this is the amount of plane tickets Eric's going to start buying. The amount of money he's going to spend on plane tickets for the next several months.
He's going to have to come here. That's funny.
He's going to like fly to Austria, then to Sweden.
We're double parked in Paris. And
man, I do it.
Look at this guy.
I might do the same thing.
You ready to depart?
Almost. 4 minutes.
Yeah, what's good, Shelly? What's good? How you doing?
Yeah.
What have we just witnessed?
Yeah. Eric making out with another woman again. He's probably in love with her for the fifth time
on
this
tour. Yeah, he's still in love right now, dude.
Is it love?
You could tell.
Now he's giving her bus money.
He's probably giving her everything he has.
Everybody got to make sure to call him a faggot when he comes over.
Is this the first time you threw it in so far?
No, but every he always hooks up and then instantly falls in love for life.
Oh, yeah. Until the next one. Okay.
Where did you sleep here?
I did. Last night.
Oh, you spent the night
there? Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Would you like to introduce yourself?
There's somebody
built in the Mark. Bathroom. Everyone calls me Choco Baco in Europe.
Choco Baco?
Yeah.
Fagstrom.
What'd you guys say? I think he had a fun time.
Nicely done.
Look at that grin.
Fucking Fagstrom.
Everybody hit him with a torrent of Fag. Wait until he's right in the doorway of the
Everybody
dam.
Go, oh.
He's covering it.
Ready? Yeah.
Ready? One.
Wait, let him get closer.
Okay, sorry. One, two, three.
Oh! Faggot!
Faggot!
I knew you were going to be filming that. I knew that somewhere Gary Lachance was zoomed in.
I'll punch a bitch in the mouth.
Will not accept that.
Will not.
Kid, draw come on. Vegas can't be choosers.
Dude, I think we can swim to that island.
That bird is gone.
We find ourselves today in
David's birthday. I mean, San Sebastian. Spain! My favorite country. Oh, he's back.
Who?
The cormorant.
Say something insightful.
Happy birthday, David.
David. How's your birthday going?
I like the beach.
Some say life's a beach.
They're wrong.
So cold! Hey, Nathan!
You're supposed
shit,
to run.
You're gonna run away.
Supposed to run.
Fuck. I didn't know what to do. Run. This is horrible. Oh, my balls fell off. Oh, shit. They both broke.
How are your spirits?
My spirits are numb to all things around me at this point.
Pourquoi?
Not gonna say my spirits are down or broken or anything like that, but they're just non-responsive to anything except for the sun. Still enjoy the sun and the sand in my toes. The lamentation of the woman.
You stressed about finances for the trip?
Not that much. We've accepted the fact that we're going to lose money.
Is that guaranteed?
Pretty much. Yeah.
Even if there's a few shows at the States, in the States?
Well, I don't even know if there's going to be any more than that one show in the States now. But I mean, we could get close enough so that the money we lose is made up for by some of the
retail money that's come in over the last couple months. So that'll be good, but either way. It's not a profitable venture.
Tonight, after David's birthday at midnight, it's Eric's birthday. So as you can understand, we're gonna be wasted.
Dios mío.
It's so weird that I find myself in this position in life. Like, I used to just want to be in a band. I wanted to tour. I'm in Spain right now, like, fucking, it's so rad. But it's, like, not as good without her here. It's sucking the life out of me, man. I can only handle so much of it. Like, if she were here, I'd be the giddiest. You're recording this. I'd be the most, like, dance party, fucking in your bed, whatever you wanted kind of guy, because she'd be right there. You would love the fuck out of her, dude. Like, you would be like, does anybody want to dance to techno? And she'd be like, yeah! And, like, right there next to you, and I'd be, like, right there next to her. So, you, like, any situation you thought of, I would be sucked into because she was there loving the fuck out of it. Oh, dude, I just want to shake it. I want to dance with her right here. On those fucking stones next to this bad smell.
Two weeks.
Dude, it's funny because I've lived, you know, 31 years and several months. And these 2 weeks seem like fucking hell and an eternity.
For sure.
God.
Well, Dash laid it out last night. We got 4 birthdays in a row.
Yeah, it's gonna come fast.
Then we have a German seduction artist. Then we're in Russia.
Which will be cool. I gotta buy my mom a present in Russia. She wants something colorful. I'm gonna buy her a Russian souvenir. Actually, you like my mom too, Gary. She's fucking hilarious. No, like, it seems weird to say that, but she is the shit. Dude. My mom, if it wasn't for my mom, I wouldn't be doing this. My dad's side is very tame, very together. They were farmers, military, you know, responsible people. And my mom's all like psychos and jailbait and like teenage pregnancies and shit, like porn stars. Like, my mom is fucking cool. Like, my mom, my sister, and both my brothers, man. I miss those. I miss all of them.
What about Savannah?
She's dead. That sucks. And her name is Shannon.
Was it?
Yeah. That's what drugs do to you, man. Drugs fuck you up. So, my cousin Shannon, she's a cool girl. She's into rock and roll. She wanted to be a movie star. She got fucked up with some rock stars. They got her into heroin and stuff, as I hear from my family. And I remember her being really cool. Kind of crazy when I was a kid. But she got into drugs and, like, she got into porn and she was, like, the super porn star. And then, yeah, she went somewhere dark. It's sad because she was probably a cool girl. She probably would have found her way out of it. She probably would have quit doing that shit eventually. And all it took was one night of bad decisions. And yeah. Like, I remember when I was, like, 7th grade, like, grade 7. She was all into Guns N' Roses. She had, like, a Guns N' Roses tattoo. And later I found out she was, like, fucking Axl Rose and Slash. Like, there was an article in fucking Spin where, like, in the middle of a bar, yeah, like, people are drinking, having fun, and, she, like, Slash was, like, fucking her on a fucking stool. Like, in the middle of the bar. And then my uncle... Was it Mike or David? I think it was... Shit. My great-grandparents, my mom's grandparents, David lived with for a while, and Mike lived with for a while. David was military, and Mike was prison. I think it was Mike. Mike was the Mike's the dude who smelled like Miller all day long. But he was saying he was like at home one day and at like 4 a.m. somebody's like banging on his window, and he opened the window and there's some dude with long red hair. He's like, "Hey, where's Shannon?" What is Axl Rose? And he's just like, "I don't fucking know." And he's like, "Hey, where's Shannon?" He's like, "Dude, get the fuck out of here." And the guy's like, "Do you know who I am?" He's like, "Yeah, fuck you." Like, straight up, like Axl Rose is all fucking rock and roll, and like, and my uncle was just like, "Dude, get the fuck out of my house, get the fuck off my lawn." And Shannon is, who the fuck knows? She's fucking Greg Allman from the Allman Brothers. That guy's more famous than you. Well, maybe, conceivably. But yeah, dude, I'm so doomed to death. Oh fuck! As long as Haley's there with me, I won't die. As long as it's a plane crash, and then I'm fucked. Ask John Carroll about that. From the number 12, Looks Like You. Very sophisticated music. Yeah, he says we're gonna die on a plane. I think I'm gonna make it home to my lady.
It's the final countdown. This on their shoulder.
Yeah! Woo!
All right. We'll continue the party later.
It's like all the jokes that I say, no one's gonna know. And then when I try and play it, freaking
Sarah.
Which would you rather? No one's gonna think it's funny.
It's the worst.
And then
nobody fucking gets it.
Like, how am I gonna see Horse the Band live?
Wait, I'm trying to think.
Dave.
Yeah?
You're sleeping in a gymnasium.
Yeah.
Here we go. What the fuck?
A spare?
Yeah.
Nice. It's bound to happen.
Oh no.
It's a McFlatsta.
At least it didn't happen in fucking Transnistria.
I'm glad it happened. I was really bored.
You can't see my balls, right?
And at midnight, it is Sarah McPlop's birthday. She's going to be 12. So we're having a very special celebration. So celebrate with your fucking carnal bodies to this song.
I think we need to turn around.
Okay.
It's so not.
Sarah.
Driving this way is stupid.
Are you excited to spend your entire birthday driving in the van?
My entire birthday?
Overnight?
Dude, I would normally be sleeping right now and waking up to celebration. So, I hope that when I wake up, there will be gifts on the loft for me.
I've got you a croissant.
You want it now
an
or later?
An array of presents.
Remember, kids, Sarah's
I got a little gift I'm going to toss up there later.
It's going to be your boner, I bet.
Sarah's never had a birthday?
No. I bet every single one of you is going to give me a boner for my birthday.
I'm going to give you a snail trail.
Yeah.
On your chinny
a Santa beard.
Eerie.
You you guys, I wake up, I'm covered in cum.
Oh my god.
Like, I'm just like a Santa beard, a fucking pearl necklace, she like a headband, a fucking sweatband.
Just gargling.
No, she's literally gonna wake up.
An ankle bracelet.
Wake up in a cum coon.
Cum coon.
She'll burst out as a fucking butterfly.
You wouldn't even be mad either.
Dude, I'd be like, what the? Who's in charge of this? Guys! Oh, guys!
Happy birthday, Sarah.
Thank
you. We need Jägermeister right now. We need some Jägermeister. We can't keep playing any more songs.
This fucking sucks. The worst day of my life. I'm so fucking bored. I'm gonna go into the second configuration. There. I am now in the second configuration. Fucking music. I hate it in Germany. So boring. Where's my Jägermeister, Gary?
A ground mattered almost
immediately. What the fuck is wrong with this country?
Untying their bodies like a pair of
fucking seagull strangled me. Not on purpose.
Gary, just help me.
Oh, shit.
Are you?
What the hell?
What happened?
What's going on up there?
Don't break your
arm. What are you doing? Eric just literally tried to kill himself.
Jason wants to know if he just vomited.
I almost strangled myself.
On what?
I hate this life.
Down the front of his pants. Oh! Oh!
What the fuck is up with his room, man?
This is art.
High School Musical 2 stickers.
Oh. Ryan.
That is Ryan.
I'll wear my hat.
Louder.
I hate Western Europe.
Me too.
Mark, is this the place?
What?
No.
We're still on the way. I can't even beat this as long.
Oh, Discordant's axis sucks.
Isn't it Discordant's axis? Discordant's axis fucking sucks.
It's gone.
Feeling any better? How about you?
I just do kegels when I'm bored.
How many? How many reps?
I don't even count, I just do them. I would do kegels if I had any reason to do them. But I don't.
You never know. You'll have sex.
One day, Eric.
Preemptive kegels.
Oh! It just improves the quality of orgasm regardless of situation, so.
Really?
Even for masturbation. Payson, how do you super start?
You guys have caught us in a special time. We're in the middle of birthday week. It was Dave's birthday, then Eric's birthday, then Sarah's birthday.
My birthday!
Today's the day off. Your birthday sucks. And then John's birthday is tomorrow.
that what goes up must come down, and what is drunk is gonna come down really fucking hard.
Tell him to go from the top.
I hear him. I'll help him.
Yeah.
Really? I beat I'd just like to say, it is not even really my birthday, because in America, it's like...
Fuck America!
A year ago or something. But you are my new friends.
Oh, yeah.
And I hope that someday I will look back at you as my old friends. And we'll celebrate many more birthdays together. Yeah.
Ha ha ha.
Wait, what was that fight you got in?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I fucking sprayed the fuck out of that guy with his beer, dude.
The white shirt dude?
And then he fucking threw his whole drink on me. And I was like, yeah! Put both thumbs up and I was like, exactly!
And like, he wasn't so stoked.
He was pissed, dude.
Yeah.
And the beer is like talking him down. And somehow, by the time I got over him to apologize, he's like, dude, it's your birthday? Awesome! Oh my God. I'm so sorry!
That fight caused me to spill another beer on myself. Because he fucking bumped it. I bought, like, fucking...
You guys are invited to have the best time of your life. Just don't touch the fucking keyboard. Don't touch the keyboard, okay, guys? You understand this, right? Officially, the strangest motherfuckers in the room. But I really